goodness with care from our villages arokya milk
welcome to episode 17 of mahabharata with anuja thank you so much for joining me for your dose of all the action at kurukshetra In the previous episode, I told you about the slaying of Jayadratha by Arjuna. Now he had fulfilled his vow, but a lot of blood had been shed and passions were running high and hostilities continued well after sundown, which was a violation of the terms of conduct they'd agreed upon. But on that night, anything went, I guess. Torches were lit and Kurukshetra looked very much like the set of a horror movie. And in the light of these torches, men continued to fight and slay each other. Now, Duryodhana turned on Drona and Karna. He was furious and he let them have the sharp edge of his tongue. He spoke to Drona first. He said, it's bad enough you did not keep your vow to me. You failed to capture Yudhishthira despite everything. But you also allowed Jayadratha to be killed. I will not forgive you for this. I trusted you, though many people warned me about you. They said you're too old. They said you're partial to the Pandavas. I did not listen, but you have betrayed the trust I placed in you. And Drona was very upset when he heard this. And then he rounded on Karna. He said, Karna, you're no better. On four separate occasions, Bhima, Yudhishthira, Nakula and Sahadeva, they were in your mercy. You could have killed them if you wanted to and ended this war. But like Yudhishthira, you also decided to be very generous and you did something extremely stupid. I really cannot handle this kind of behavior from both of you. You better do your best by me or else, you know, and he really left the threat hanging there. And both of them had been yelled at in front of all the troops. So it was like, you know, they were really charged up after that. And they launched a very, very savage counter-attack. They no longer looked like, you know, the respectable Drona and the handsome Karna. Both of them were like beasts of prey, just snarling and attacking everyone in the vicinity. Now, Yudhishthira turned to Arjuna and he said, I'm very scared. Karna is terror incarnate. Do something. And Arjuna told Krishna, why don't you take the chariot towards him? Let me put that fellow in his place. Krishna pretended he hadn't heard him and he turned to Ghatotkacha. Ghatotkacha is Bhima's son, as you know, and Krishna said, the time has come for you to serve this family. Do you remember what Karna did to Abhimanyu? Abhimanyu was a good friend of yours and your cousin. Do you know what Karna did? Do you want me to refresh your memory? He broke his bow from behind, so you have to put an end to this menace tonight. And Ghatotkacha immediately rose to the challenge and he called all his Rakshasa hordes. Now everyone knew that the Rakshasas were very comfortable in the dark. That was when they were in their element. And Ghatotkacha said, anyway, these fellows have violated the rules of combat. They're fighting after sundown. So even I will use my magic against the mortals. And obviously that was a very, very uneven battle. And Ghatotkacha did untold damage, okay? Now, Duryodhana didn't know how to combat this threat. He sent for Alambusha, one of the Rakshasas on their side, and he asked him to attack Ghatotkacha. But it was not at all an even battle, and Ghatotkacha sliced off his head and he picked it up by the hair and he tossed it into Duryodhana's chariot. And he said, keep waiting, I'll send another gift for you. This time it will be your best friend's head. And Ghatotkacha was completely consumed by bloodlust. You know, troops threw down their weapons because they had no answer for his magic and for his black magic and sorcery, I should say. So they threw down their weapons and they begged for mercy. But on that night, Ghatotkacha was simply not in the mood. He destroyed all of them indiscriminately. And there was so much panic among the Kauravas. It was dark, nobody could see anything, and all around people were dying. So they fled to Karna and they threw themselves at his feet. They said, at least Arjuna, he respects a fallen foe. This Ghatotkacha is a monster. Please save us from him. Please use the Shakti against him. And everybody on all sides, they were begging Karna to do this, and Karna hesitated because he wanted the Shakti given to him by Indra, which can be used only once, for Arjuna. And all of them were pressuring him like this, and he was known for his generosity, he cannot say no. And at that point, Duryodhana came and he turned the screws. His eyes looked absolutely crazed and he said, Karna, are you deaf? Ghatotkacha is destroying this army. Use the Shakti. And finally, Karna had no choice. He released this weapon with a sigh, and of course it was invincible, and Ghatotkacha saw it hurtling towards him, and in that moment he knew he was going to die. All the anger left him very graciously, with there was so much acceptance in him, and his last thought was, before I depart this world, I must do one more service for my family. And he allowed his already gigantic body to become massive, and he kept growing, 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 and the Shakti hurled into his chest found its mark, and he died right there. And as he fell, he gathered momentum, and his body, and under that huge body of his, he crushed an entire division of the Kaurava army. And again, the Pandavas were heartbroken because they had lost another son, and they were all weeping and hugging each other, and Krishna alone was smiling a little bit. And Arjuna said, what the hell are you doing? Is it like something to smile about, Krishna? He's Bhima's son. And Krishna immediately told him, see, Karna could use that Shakti only once, and he was saving it for you, but he's used it against Ghatotkacha, so he's helpless now. And Arjuna said, no, it's still not fair. I don't want Ghatotkacha to die for me. And Krishna said, see, he's a Rakshasa and he was destined to die. He's done lots of horrible things to helpless people. And I would have had to kill him at the end of the war if he'd survived. I'm glad it happened this way. And Arjuna also had to make his peace with this, and he calmed down a bit. And meanwhile, on the Kaurava side, now Drona decided to prove his mettle, because everyone was cheering for Karna, the slayer of Ghatotkacha. And Drona was, everyone said he should be the commander, not that useless old man. So Drona was like, I'll show them all. And he also started fighting like some sort of demon. He released, he got the idea from Ghatotkacha. He started releasing all the celestial missiles, which were not to be used against regular soldiers, because they would have absolutely no defense against it. It's like attacking a baby or something. And Drona stooped to that level, and he fought like a madman, and he did, and he claimed a lot of lives that were very dear to the Pandavas. First, the grand old man of Matsya, King Virata, who had offered them shelter during the final year of exile, he was killed. But before that, he had to endure the loss of all his sons at the hands of Drona. And finally, the grand old man was killed himself, and this was a big loss to the Pandavas. And before they could recover from it, he also killed every one of Drupada's grandsons, Drishtadyumna's sons. And when Drupada tried to get his revenge, Drupada was also killed by Drona. And Krishna pointed this out to the Pandavas. He said, see, your guru, he's using all these missiles against our regular soldiers. He's killing everyone who's close to us. You boys need to do something. And as usual, Arjuna refused to meet Krishna's gaze, because Drona was his guru and he refused to harm him in any way. So Krishna turned to Yudhishthira, and very slyly he whispered to him. He said, do you remember what Drona told you at the beginning of the battle when you went and asked for his blessing? And Yudhishthira's memory was jogged a bit, and he remembered. Drona would have told him, the only way for you to defeat me is if I'm made to lay down my weapons, and I will do that only if I'm given extremely bad news by someone I trust. And when Yudhishthira remembered this, he shut his eyes in shame. And Krishna immediately said, it is not a time for fine scruples. Do what is needed. Go and tell him that Ashwatthama is dead. He'll believe it only if you say it, because everybody knows that you will not utter falsehoods. And Yudhishthira said, I cannot do it. I cannot do it. Let's think of some other way. I don't want to lie to my guru. And then Bhima stepped forward. Your guru, you and Arjuna are going to celebrate your love for your guru now. What answer are you going to give to Drishtadyumna here? He watched all his sons die. That was not enough. He watched his father also die. Go tell him. Go tell him Drona's your beloved guru, and see how happy he's going to feel. In a battlefield, you have to get blood on your hands. We made a commitment. Let's do this. And he told Yudhishthira, if you can't lie, I'll take care of it for you. And there was a king there, a Malava king named Indravarma, and he had an elephant named Ashwatthama. So Bhima went, he found this elephant, and he smashed its skull in with his mace and killed that poor creature. I'm sorry, animal rights activists, but he did it. And then he placed his mace on his shoulder, and he called out to Drona. He said, Drona, I've killed Ashwatthama. and he went on his way like that laughing. And Drona immediately, you know, he was just paralyzed with shock. And then slowly he recovered. He was like, Bhima is a liar. This can't be true. My heart won't continue beating if my son is dead. And he continued releasing missile after missile. And then Bhima turned around and he said again, what sort of father are you? I just told you that Ashwatthama is dead. You have no heart. And he taunted him like that. He said, it's bad enough that you're the reason we are all in this situation. You should have been a man of prayer and peace. Instead, you've taught us all how to be warriors. And now you are also turning your skills against us. And he's taunting him like this. And Drona just couldn't bear it. And then he turned to Yudhishthira. He said, is it true? Is it true? Is my son dead? And Yudhishthira, he said, Ashwatthama is dead. And then in a very soft voice, he said, the elephant. So, you know, they say his chariot had been elevated 4 fingers above the ground because of his faultless conduct. But when that half-truth was uttered, his chariot immediately lowered to the ground. And Drona didn't notice all these things. He was too heartbroken. He thought, you know, it's only a cursed father who lives after his son has died. I no longer want to have any part of this world. And he dropped all his weapons and he sat down in a state of yogic meditation. He started preparing to sever his soul from his body. And it was at this precise moment that Drishtadyumna charged with all the hatred and anger of the blood feud that had gone on between Drupada and Drona. He charged and Arjuna ran to stop him, but Drishtadyumna cut off Drona's head and it rolled on the floor. And Arjuna just couldn't stand it. He said, why did you have to kill him? You could have at least taken him captive. What harm was he doing? He dropped all his weapons. Shame on you, Drishtadyumna. He's your guru as well as mine. And then Drishtadyumna got very, very angry. He said, don't talk to me about honor and all. That fellow, he killed my father and my sons. What did you do when your son was killed? You took care of the man responsible, right? And you did use tricks as well. So don't lecture me on morality. I did the right thing. Nobody has the right to question me. And Drishtadyumna turned and walked off. And again, with their commander fallen, all the troops ran screaming from the battlefield. And with that, I'll conclude this section of the Mahabharata. I hope you enjoyed it. Do let me know your thoughts on all the events that went down in this episode. I love hearing from you. And please do hit like, share and subscribe to this channel. Until next time, take care.
Goodness with care. From our villages, Arokya Milk.